about a double decker seat where if you're in the back row, you're almost essentially lying underneath the passenger in front of you?
This does seem a little crowded.
No way, no how, no money, no deal.
In aviation, innovation often meets the sky-high challenge of balancing passenger comfort, regulatory compliance, and economic viability. Double-decker airline seats, a concept aimed at optimizing cabin space, seem to capture the industry's imagination from time to time. But are these designs feasible for commercial flight? Or should we be paying less attention to them since there are too many regulatory hurdles standing in the way? In this video, we'll look at the concept, some real-world examples, and why we're yet to see double-decker airline seats on commercial aircraft today. Back in February 2020, we put out a video on our main Simple Flying YouTube channel titled "Fully Flat Beds in Economy Class? This company has the answer." For our relatively young and budding channel, it quickly became one of the most popular videos in our collection, generating excitement for travelers hoping to one day get a comfortable snooze in economy class on a long-haul flight. About a year later, the company Zephyr Aerospace burst onto the scene, again providing us with something to talk about. At the time, the company achieved 700% of its crowdfunding goal, promising a seat which could provide affordable lie-flat comfort in the economy cabin. However, according to NerdWallet, the idea of double-decker seating in airplanes is nothing new. One of the earliest concepts dates back to a 1948 patent by Paul David Preeb, which envisioned a two-level seating arrangement. The design featured upper-deck passengers facing outwards with large windows and lower-deck passengers with work tables. As it's probably clear to most people, this concept has yet to make it into production. Indeed, despite numerous iterations and patents since then, none have taken flight commercially. More recent designs have attempted to address both comfort and capacity issues. The chaise lounge economy seat, introduced by Alejandro Núñez Vicente at the 2022 Aircraft Interiors Expo, proposes a staggered seating layout. This design promised more recline, more legroom, and more privacy by arranging seats in two levels, with passengers either sitting on the upper deck or the lower deck with leg support. Despite the innovative approach, the design remains in the conceptual phase. Even giants like Airbus explored a similar idea in 2015, with the European plane maker patenting a design that stacked passengers vertically. The public's reaction was overwhelmingly adverse, with critiques comparing the design to bunk beds or stacked blocks. Airbus clarified that the patent was merely an exploration of ideas, not an imminent product launch. While these designs offer creative solutions to increase passenger capacity, they face significant challenges. First is passenger acceptance. The concept of double-decker seats often faces resistance from potential passengers. Concerns about comfort, claustrophobia, and the flying experience can be significant deterrents. The adverse reactions to Airbus's 2015 design exemplify passengers' skepticism and discomfort towards such layouts. Weight and cost is another consideration. Adding a second level of seating significantly increases the aircraft's weight, impacting fuel efficiency and operating costs. While costs per passenger could be driven down with such concepts, assuming all seats are filled, the industry hasn't really had to consider such high weight densities for their aircraft. And then, of course, there are safety regulations. Aviation safety standards regarding head injury criteria during turbulence or accidents are stringent. Designs that place passengers' heads close to complex structures face substantial hurdles in meeting these safety requirements. Staying on the topic of safety, imagine a rushed evacuation with such high passenger densities. It would be a challenge, only made worse by smoke filling the cabin. Yes, ensuring double-decker seats comply with all safety regulations without compromising passenger comfort is a complex challenge. Other practical considerations stand in the way as well. Many readers commenting on our companion article on the Simple Flying website highlight the fact that stacked seating eliminates overhead baggage compartments and that it simply leaves little to no space for cabin baggage. Another commenter remarked, "The way I spill peanuts and other people spilling drinks, what could go wrong?" Indeed, the double-decker arrangement could get messy. However, even if we assume passengers manage their messes adequately, it would still require longer turnaround times at airports as cleaning crews may find themselves having to climb up and down to vacuum seat cushions and empty seat back pockets. Additionally, political debate over seat sizes and safety regulations continue, with legislation introduced to reassess evacuation rules and consider passengers' diverse needs. This ongoing regulatory scrutiny adds another complexity to implementing double-decker seating. Despite the technical and regulatory challenges, double-decker seating intrigues designers and engineers. Companies have invested in patents for layered lie-flat seats aimed at business class, suggesting a persistent interest in maximizing space innovatively. Moreover, the economic pressures on airlines to maximize revenue per flight make such innovations appealing, in theory. The potential to offer more seats without increasing the aircraft's footprint is tempting. However, until a design can convincingly address passenger comfort, regulatory compliance, and economic feasibility, it's unlikely that double-decker seats will become a standard feature in commercial aviation. Yes, the journey of double-decker airline seats from concept to reality is fraught with challenges. While the idea has persisted for decades, evolving through various innovative designs, it has yet to surmount the significant barriers posed by passenger acceptance, weight and cost implications, and stringent safety regulations. We've heard essentially nothing from the more recent double-decker seating concepts, nothing new about the economy class bunk bed idea put forward by the Delft University of Technology, nor anything from Zephyr Aerospace. Zephyr's website, at least at the time of making this video, is no longer accessible, and their YouTube channel has not posted a new video for several years now. We should note, however, that one multi-deck concept has made it to the market, the Air New Zealand Skynest. Technically, at the time of making this video, its entry into service has been delayed, but the airline promises to offer this to passengers in 2025. In case you haven't yet heard about Skynest, it'll be a 6-pod configured sleep zone that offers sessions for economy passengers to lie down when travelling long haul. Originally slated to enter service in September 2024, it's now been reported that it will enter service with Air New Zealand's new 787 Dreamliners in 2025. As described by the airline, each pod will include a full-size pillow, sheets and blanket, earplugs, a separate reading light, and a USB outlet. Passengers will be limited to one session, with families travelling on the same ticket able to book a session for each passenger, pending availability. This feature will be located between premium economy and economy, and each pod will come with a separate seatbelt. Bedding will be changed between each session, and a 30-minute transition time will be allowed for this. While price has yet to be finalised, the airline initially estimates $400 to $600 for the 4-hour period. If we assume these figures are New Zealand dollars, then the US equivalent is about $235 to $350. But while it is somewhat of a double-decker concept, it is definitely a far cry from the stacked seating of a full cabin that other concepts aim to deliver. But what's your position on the concept of double-decker seating? If it could lower the cost of your airfare or provide more space and comfort, is it something you would consider? Share your thoughts and opinions with us by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.